Well, well. Oh, my goodness gracious. Friends, how's everybody doing? Man, that patch that we just come out of, pretty crazy. I mean, I'm used to them. It's alder, friends. It's just alder and maple. And for some reason, in there, there's water. And alders and hardwood like that, they like the water. But too much water can drown trees, as we know. You know what? I don't feel like talking shop right now. I just don't. I want to talk about some other stuff. And I'm actually going to send this video out to you right now. Why? Well, you know why. Hey, I saw longer wait on a freaking commercial for Axeman. I did. I saw him. That's so cool. I love it. Hey, longer wait. Buddy, can you believe this, pal? Did you think in a million years? God, I remember seeing longer wait on freaking YouTube. I was like, what is this guy doing? I really like Logger Wade. You know what I liked about Logger Wade right away? Is he knew he didn't, you know, he knew what he was. He's grown up in a logging family, and he got on a power saw probably quite young like myself, and probably just started going and cutting. I like Logger Wade because he shows his mistakes and he talks about exactly what he is. He knows what he is, and he doesn't think he's anything else other than what he is. I like that in a man. And I've always liked Logger Wade, and he is going to be incredible on this TV show, The Axeman. I'm honored to share that with him. I can't even believe it. He was the first guy, friends, that gave me a shout-out on YouTube. He was the first man to do it. Yeah, who's that there? Now? Oh, it's Frank from Indiana. Do you want to know something else, Frank? So I'm wrapping Frankie's axe up today for him. I'm actually... It's Monday. Okay, that didn't feel that great. It's Monday, friends. Okay, I think it's Monday. Is it Monday? Yeah, I think it is. It is Monday. And I've been busy cutting. So now, this week, believe it or not, even like the next couple days, is I got to get axes out. I want to get axes out. So that's kind of what I'm going to do. But here's the funny thing. I get a hold of Frankie because he's a guy that bought an axe. And I said, Frank, I want your freaking phone number. And I want it in my phone so we can be friends forever. Forever and ever. And we are that. And we will continue to be that. So I says to Frankie this morning, Frank, because you know how unorganized I am. I'm like, Frankie, I need your address. I'm sending a double bait your way today. And he's like, oh, no way. Friends, it's Frankie's birthday today. It's his birthday. I believe he turns 59. Did you say 59, Franco? Let's see. I can find out right now. Frank is a really good guy, friends. He bought an axe, and he's like, he's 59. Friends, I want to wish Frank a happy freaking birthday from this community today. Okay, I'll ship this out to us, and we'll get this out to Frankie today. He's a great fella. Frank, are you coming to Buckenstock? Which is another, friends, this year's nuts. It's going to be crazy. I feel like showing Frankie what he's getting. Did you already see it, Frank? It's a little bit of a surprise. And birthdays should have surprises in them. I believe so. So I'm not going to show you, Frank. You're going to have to wait, okay? And I just finished wrapping up Lonnie Chartrand's axe. The guy who won the axe, friends. Okay, so that's what we're doing. We're doing it today. Well, it's not a day off when you do YouTube and work for yourself. There isn't days off. So anyways, friends, people have been asking me about this axe I got hanging on my neck. I was down in Victoria. Remember the day I went down to Victoria with my wife and we walked through the woods and she was giving us some camera goodies? That was awesome of her to do that. Well, it's this little thing. We're shopping. We're down in Victoria. We're doing girl stuff, okay? I'm comfortable with my feminine side. It's no problem. I don't mind it. So anyway, it's just an axe. It's not gold, but it jumped out at me right away. And it was kind of a girl store, but they had all these cool pendants. And come on. They had seven of them. I almost bought all seven of them just to give them away, you know. But Isn't that neat, friends? So anyways, I it's not a gift from anybody out there. It's a gift to me. I bought it for myself. And it's not, I think it's brass. So I'm hoping it'll tarnish up. My wife says, don't wear it in the shower. It'll go all green and goofy. I said, perfect. That's what I want. Something busted up and green and rusty and goofy. So that's what's kind of going on with that. So thanks for asking. Welcome to our new subscribers on the channel. I see you coming in. We are at 54,992 right on the wall there. You probably won't see it because it's quite a ways away, but it's right there on our counter. Jason. What a guy giving us that. So we're almost at 55,000. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. And I think that might have something to do with just the fact that we're growing is why. But, excuse me. It is the show thing. I think maybe just a few of the videos, you know, where we talk about maybe the Axemen, maybe people have done some investigating on Old Buck and Billy Ray, perhaps. Not sure. But it seems that subscribers kind of took a little bit more of a move, which is cool. Because then we get to share this wonderful channel and community with people, which actually is the part that excites me the most, is maybe more people. Like maybe yourself, I don't know if you came here and I don't know what stood out for you, whether you enjoyed the power saws, which you may have, maybe you did, but you over there, you may have thought, hey, this guy's talking about being nice to people. That's interesting. Because that's the main message of this channel, is being kind to people. And the cool thing is, friends, is that we're actually growing. So, which means that more people will maybe open a door for somebody or just have that extra little thought through the day that, forget it, maybe Buckin's right. Maybe I should just say hi to that fella or open the door or maybe buy that guy's coffee behind me in the freaking drive-thru. Maybe I should just go for it. Do you know how that feels when you're driving in a drive-thru and you pull up to the counter to pay your freaking coffee and your whatever and the ladies or whoever says, That guy got it in front of you there. He got it for you. Do you know how that feels? It's happened to me, and that feels wonderful. You're like, good on the guy, and it makes you do it. So I did it. We had one rolling at the South End there one day. I think it went for, she goes, you're the seventh one in a row. And I was like, yes, that's deadly. So it's pretty cool. So we got a guy outside painting. My wife phoned a painter dude. So he's out there and he's painting and I'm in here doing this and yelling and screaming and hooting and hollering at you guys. And he thinks I'm nuts. He thinks I'm nuts. He's right. So the banner right there. Very cool. I had four. Remember my 2100s, friends, how I kind of acquired them there over the last 3 years. I acquired some 2100s, okay? I bought one, I had two given to me, actually. Two of them, the power saws. The guy did not use it anymore, did not want to start it. He was getting older. He says, if you can start it, you can have it. Well, of course, what happened? I started it, I took it home with me. And then another guy had about two or three of them, and he gave me another one. Brad, you're probably not watching, but if you ever do, buddy, I love you. Thanks, buddy. Actually, I think I got to get up to your place and cut a tree, if I'm not mistaken. Ivan, check this out, friends. This is cool. I'm glad I started this video. This is fun. This is off the cuff. I kind of like stuff like that, don't you? Sure you do. Let's go hitchhiking today. Might as well. Check this out. U.S. Forest Service. Yeah, it's pretty cool. So the neat thing is about it is the fella sent me this axe and he would like me to rehandle it for him and to turn it into a bucking special. And I'd be freaking honored to do that because that's going to come up deadly. And the beaver tooth handles. Beaver tooth, they fit in here like nobody's business. They're designed for this. I don't have it out right now, but I think I have another. What was that racket? Oh, it's AJ. It's freaking AJ. Oh, yeah. Speaking of double bits, AJ. That's another thing I'm doing this week. Shipping some old stuff out to my buddy, AJ. He's on the WhatsApp, friends. I got so many friends on the WhatsApp from the channel that I met. What's he got going here now? Let's check in on AJ. Oh, dear. Well, we can't show that right now. AJ, thank you. Here's the deal. This is interesting. my buddy that I was falling with that one time, remember Dayton, friends? Me and the boy were falling with him one day. Forest Service, right there. He gave me the axe. It's a true temp, right there. Kelly Works. Black Prince. Well, look at this. Here's U.S. Forest Service. True Temper. Flint Edge, Kelly Works. Same company, same thing. BC. This is forestry in BC, and that's the U.S. Forest Service. Pretty cool stuff. So True Temper had quite a gig there going on. So that's pretty cool. So that's going to be, I'm going to restore that. And I'm going to restore it on the video, on the YouTube channel. You know this YouTube channel we got going here, friends? Yeah, I'm going to do that on here with the original handle, which is going to be very nice. I was wondering where Bobby was. He just texted me. What else? There was a couple other things I wanted to chat about. A couple of gifts came in, friends, from folks. Listen, if you've sent me a gift, and you haven't seen it unboxed on the channel, or if you just haven't even heard of it, friends, I wish I had the proper words to convey to you the time that you take to pack up something or go down to the post office, do whatever, and ship me something. It warms my heart. But friends, we've grown. There's so much on the go right now that every gift that comes in, whether it's a small one or a letter or a card or a power saw, they don't all hit the channel now. They don't. I used to make every single one on the channel just like I welcomed every freaking subscriber until we hit 5,000 or some freaking thing. I forget. But so if you have and you have not heard or seen it be unboxed on the channel, from my heart, thank you so much. From my family, from the channel, from the community, thank you for your gifts. I appreciate the heck out of them. I always get excited to open them. It's fun as hell. It's like Christmas all the time here, right? So thank you all so much. It's exciting. Now, friends, I think that's about it. One thing I want to talk about real quick. X-Men Reborn. July 11th. Tune in to the History Channel. Unfortunately, I won't be able to because I think we don't get it. We're in Canada. So I don't think we get it. Hats off to you. I think we get it later, August or something like that. Yeah. What can you say? I'm a Canadian. I don't have. Hey, Billy, friends, remember Billy sent the beautiful 44, sent some goodies here the other day, and we opened them up, and he sent that axe head, the stiletto, and that. As a matter of freaking fact, where are you? Yeah. Okay. So remember the stiletto that came with the 44 and all that, friends? Look at this handle. Look at it. He wanted the stiletto. He wanted it. So I made it right away for him. Okay? And I'm telling you right now, friends.
It's just, listen, Whiskey River, buddy. I love your handles, buddy. I love them. They are really, really nice.
They feel good. They feel like a competitive. They got a good, you know, they're really good. And if you want a wedge bang, like straight handles, what I use, but I'll bang a wedge with anything. It don't matter, but I usually use straight handle. But if you've got an axe that you love to use banging wedges and you find that their little curve might get in your way, choke up on it a little bit. Just grab it straight and kick your can out a little bit so when you swing, you don't come across with the butt and smack yourself in the hip bone or something. Just choke up on it a little bit. You know, if you like using that axe. So, Billy LeCount, your axe is done and I'm shipping it out to you within probably this week. It's going to sit for a little bit. I'm going to test run it again, make sure she's seated. It ain't freaking going anywheres. I've really had good success with this system, friends. I don't know if there's anybody out there that right now that are watching this video that have got my axes. And if you've beaten the pulp out of them in there, they haven't moved. And I get those emails, eh, Buckin? She's still okay hanging in there. I've just had really good success with this system, friends. you know, having it proud a little bit like that. And I don't wedge much anymore. I don't steel wedge my stuff too much anymore. I just don't. And you know why I don't? I'll tell you why. Because I've got so many axes that I've had of my own that I have been splitting with, banging wedges with. If it's a wedge banger, I probably do put steel wedges in it. That's a lot of force banging wedges, okay? But, I mean, you guys know this. This is one of my favorite axes. It's the No Name. It's a freaking beauty on a 32-inch handle. Here's another one that I just made. My beautiful bluegrass. It just splits the wood apart like mad. It's just freaking gorgeous, friends. Like, it just is. It's a beautiful, beautiful axe. And I just don't, I'm not getting slippage. I'm not getting, I haven't for pretty much the whole time since I've been doing this. I have had a couple slip, and it's been on that Arvika with the, what do you call it? The linseed oil when they soak it. And then later on down the road, it'll dry out, you see? So, oh man, but that Jatoba, man, the Lip Rippers Jatoba wedges, I'm able to just hammer on them. I'm kind of rambling, aren't I? Yeah, so, Axemen. Pretty appropriate for this camp anyways, isn't it? Okay, friends, that's about it. Thank you again for supporting the channel, our messengers of kindness upon the wall. Thank you, friends, for hanging in there with us. Be kind out there, friends. Follow your dreams. Just, friend, life's, I don't know about you, but I'm 50. I'm 50 years old. My kids are growing up. Time seems to be going fast. I don't know about you. Me and my wife were talking to Rita last night about some stuff. We were like, you know, honey, you can do what you want and be happy. And we were just having like a father-daughter talk and a mother talk. And it was great. But you could see at 16 years old, she's kind of like, yeah, shut up, mom and dad. No, she wasn't. She wasn't like that. But my point is, time flies, friends. Time flies. The quicker you can get on to doing things that nurtures the spirit, that when you're doing them, you feel good. You know what I mean? I mean, what's it all about? What is it all about? Be kind, friends. Help each other out. Keep your eyes peeled for the elderly, you know, needing a hand, packing stuff and opening doors out there. Let's keep our elderly moving along smoothly. They've been beat up for years and pulling us along, so let's help them out. Over and out, friends. Love yous all.